I've been attending Contemporary Forms since 2003. It gives me what I need to treat my patients. Medicine changes over time, and CT always lets me know what's happening now.
I was able to do an IUD insertion pre-conference, which really helped me to brush up on those clinical skills.
The Bible of contraceptive technology has informed me for my entire career. The conference, it's a reflection of the book in as much as we have all of the authors assembled.
These are the people who are the giants of that academic work.
But that's a gigantic study of 7,000 women. They are being followed for HIV and STI acquisition as well as unintended pregnancy. So that will provide the definitive answer.
I heard people approach topics that I have not heard approached so well, especially the sexual desire disorder, dealing with all of the PCOS complications and how complicated that topic is.
Clinicians need to understand the whole spectrum of sexual preferences that people have and to address them in a sensitive way.
And I'm learning new things and validating a lot of things that I do. Contemporary Forums has more time for individual questions and panels, and I got to hug Bob Hatcher today, so that was really great too.
Maya Angelou said, "I'll forget what you said, I'll forget what you did, but I'll never forget how you made me feel." My main talk was about how 10 patients, all women, made me feel. This conference has been a success because of the people we've had coming to it and the people we've had giving the lectures and providing the information and doing the hands-on training.
We've kind of changed the meeting itself over the years. It's almost like two tracks. One is for newbies who want to really solidify their knowledge and feel confident in what they're doing. And then we have the people who are cutting edge, but they want to know more. They want to find out what the latest and greatest is.
Speakers from a variety of backgrounds are intent on providing take-home messages, tools in terms of how to take care of your patients once you get back home.
One of the funnest things that I'm going to be doing here is wandering around the floor, and I've got a little model here to show people an easy way to remove the contraceptive implant. There are some ways that they're not teaching in the formal classes, but I know people will really benefit from.
The question we ask ourselves at the end of the day is this going to help somebody when they go back to clinic tomorrow?
Putting that education piece out so that people are not afraid of contraception, I think, is one of the biggest challenges.
66 different sizes of condoms available. But first you need to know what size. And that's not something you can take to a shoe store and just them.
Live streaming and on demand really enables so many more people to have access to this cutting edge information that's being presented here today.
I've attended the Contraceptive Technology Conference in the past, and it's fabulous. I've already obtained a vast amount of knowledge that I feel I can take back to my peers in the field.
The dedication that each of the people has to education and to interacting with each of the participants, I think that makes this a special meeting.